if McBride is able to continue to demonstrate throughout the offseason, now in training camp practices and preseason games, that he can consistently hit that three-pointer shot, that's going to be Quickley's role. You know, when we talk about Quickley playing off ball, whether it's with Rose, whether it's with Kemba, you know, Quickley's role is going to be a little bit different than what we saw this offseason in Summer League, where he's going to be more of the off-ball guard, or less. That's what I anticipate. And his role is now is going to be to be a knockdown shooter. And if we're looking at percentages, his percentage this summer in Summer League wasn't as high as you would want it to. So let's say we get to a point where he's not hitting shots consistently, and then his defense is not up to par as he's gotten stronger to improve that. McBride is waiting in the wings.
You know, the thing with IQ, obviously the three-point shot is his strength, right? We needed him to go out there and be a sniper last year, and he certainly gave us that. 39% from three, he was solid, especially when Rose came here and you were able to use Quickley primarily off ball. I thought he was great there. Low turnover percentage, which was tops in the league as well. His ability to draw fouls. You know, 62nd percentile in terms of shooting foul draw rate, 92nd percentile in terms of non-shooting foul draw rate. You know, Quickley certainly had his strengths. To me, the biggest thing is the intermediate range, John. I mean, didn't attack the rim as much. Only 8% of his shots came at the rim. Only 6 drives per game. 40% from two, which is what really knocked down his effective field goal percentage. It's only 40%. So I think the intermediate game is really a question mark, because it's kind of like floater or bust for him right now. So what do you think about that?
No, I'm with you. I think he needs to improve his shot variety. He's either taking a three or he's taking a floater. I mean, he took 17-foot floaters last year. Yeah, I'm not being sarcastic. Yeah. The dude took 17-foot floaters.
Yeah.
Like, you should not be taking 17-foot floaters. It just is a low percentage shot. And I agree. I think getting to the rim is important all the way, because I think sometimes he settles for the floater when he doesn't have to. Mm-hmm. But yeah, I agree. I think he needs to pull some of that mid-range Deuce McBride off the dribble stuff and put it into his game. And honestly, I think a lot of it has to do with the way he shoots his jump shot. I think he has trouble moving side to side and then quickly rising and releasing. He's a little bit of a lower release. Mm. And I don't think his jumper is very flexible in the way he's able to shoot it from different angles off the dribble, contorting his body. I think in that area, his game is still a little bit stiff. And I think he's worried and you see him sometimes hesitate, even on his threes, mm-hmm. that if a guy's coming to close out, his shot's going to get blocked because his release is a little bit lower. And I think that's this is me playing psychiatrist here. Mm-hmm. My thought is that in that mid-range area, he's worried that if a guy's, you know, the big man's playing that drop coverage, if he tries to pull up for that mid-range, they're going to come out, contest, and block the shot.
Yeah.
So he needs to either get that out of his head or actually make his release a little bit higher. I would not mess with his form on his jump shot. It's too good to play with it. But I think he passes up too many opportunities, even from three, but mid-range as well, because of his inability to kind of get that shot up quickly in contested situations. So I think that's something he has to improve on. And by the way, that upper body flexibility to get those mid-range jump shots off will also help him at the rim too, where he can be a little bit more creative with his finishing. So I do think that's something he needs to work on.
You know, any player that has, you know, any type of length, any type of size can kind of, you know, alter the way that they're shooting the ball. And I do think it's a kind of like a mental thing, and his inability to have confidence in shooting those mid-range. It's a little bit of the shooting mechanics that he's dealing with early on in his career, but he has no choice. He's going to have to figure out a way
because
he's not a 6'4 guard, right? And I think part of the his savviness early on, in terms of when he comes off the pick, he kind of, you know, leans on the guard, so the guard trails him, and that gives him the spacing to hit the teardrop close to the basket. You see Chris Paul do it. Mm-hmm. You see a lot of small guards develop those moves, and it's because of their size. You have to, you know, use some of the tricks like Trae Young, mm-hmm, right? Mm-hmm. But you have the NBA referee, and it's going to change a little bit now, right? And we saw a little bit of it in Summer League where
we did
try to get some of those calls. And he was looking around trying to see like what's going on.
Yep.
That's going to be an adjustment for him. And that's why, as I mentioned before, the counter to that is going to be hitting the mid-range shot, hitting the baby jumper, pulling up, not shooting, you know, as John says, those 17 foot floaters. He's going to have to develop it, especially if he wants a long career in the NBA. And if he's personally looking to be more than, you know, a player off the bench, you have to think about other areas on the court that you want to develop. And as he's entering in year two, with Kemba in front of him, with Rose in front of him, this organization, this coaching staff sees quickly as a very important piece to any success or failure that the Knicks will have next season. So, you know, let's see what he does here in preseason. I think, as I mentioned, his role is going to be an off-ball scorer. I think in summer league, they tried him at the one to develop those skills because, again, it's a long season, man. And what's the over and unders that Kemba and Rose are going to play 82 games? Right. So you're going to see situations where quickly may have to play emergency minutes, may have to even start a few games at point guard. You have to develop those skills and have them understand those assignments, you know, so that when you're in that situation, you're prepared.
His three-point shot is so vital to what the Knicks are going to do this year to spread the floor. He's got to be out there for 20 minutes a game. And here's why, real simple. How is he hurting you? He's not an awful – is he a great defender? No, but he's a good enough defender where he's not killing you. And you don't need him to carry the offense as a ball handler. So how is his presence on the court hurting you? He's got to be out there for 20 minutes a game. Figure out a way to do it. I don't care how. Figure out a way. He's got to be out there at least 20 to 25 minutes a game.